Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. My name is Z and today I'm going to be drawing Esther from Orphan. If you guys haven't seen Orphan, I definitely recommend you guys watch this movie. It is really good and it's one of my favorite horror movies that I've ever watched. I've loved the first one that was released in 2009, and I've also loved the recent one that was released, which is a direct prequel to the first one. And it's called Orphan First Kill, and this is actually a picture from Orphan First Kill. And I really wanted to do another drawing of Esther from the first one, just like the kind of like the poster, the like original poster of that. But I decided to do this picture because I saw this other drawing on Instagram and YouTube from an artist that I follow, and his name is Jose Canella. He's a great artist. I will put his link in the description if you guys want to check out his videos. He does amazing art. He draws a lot of different things, a lot of different characters from movies, and you just anyone, like celebrities and stuff, and he's a really great artist. And I was really inspired to draw this because of the blacklight drawing that he did of Esther. And so this is me kind of recreating that drawing. And you guys will see how it turns out when it's all finished. Yeah, so I just wanted to like let that be known. This is actually my first full-length time-lapse video that I'm doing for it's the start of a series that I'm doing for the whole month of October. You know, I'm drawing a bunch of scary characters, horror characters, for this upcoming spooky season, because I love Halloween. I love all things horror in general, even when it's not spooky season, even when it's not October. I just love horror in general. It's one of my favorite genres of film and TV and things like that. So yeah, I had so much fun drawing this particular character, as insane as she is. I don't want to spoil anything for you guys who haven't seen this movie, but yeah, definitely give this a watch after this video if you guys haven't seen it. But for those who have seen it, you know what I'm talking about. Esther, which really, I mean, you know what, I'm not gonna say anything else because I feel like I'll just spoil it for those who haven't seen it. So yeah, I'll pop in again to tell you guys a little bit about this drawing and, you know, what I'm doing as I go on. And but for now, I'm just gonna let you guys watch. I'm gonna shut up and let you guys watch this time lapse. Later on, I'll peek back in. Hey guys, so I'm back and I just want to talk a little bit about what I'm doing here. I'm just kind of shading and putting all the shadowing in Esther's face here. Now this was a bit tricky. I also didn't mention that I usually don't apply color to my drawings. I kind of just draw with just pencil. And I mean, I've always done that. I've been so used to doing that, but lately I've just been wanting to kind of just like break out of my own comfort zone and wanted to start to use color in my drawings, because I look at so many other artists and how they, you know, use color and they kind of just follow this technique in, as far as blending goes. And so I've been trying to do that a lot. I actually did a drawing with color, and it's actually up on my channel, but it's not a full length time lapse. It's just like on a short, and it's of Moana. So you guys can go to my channel and see that little short time lapse that I did. It's not even a time lapse, really. It's just like it's a short that I did of Moana. And I am actually very, very proud of how that drawing turned out, because I was not expecting for it to turn out as good as I thought it would, because it was my first time trying to color in. It was my first time using color with a drawing, okay? Because I said I was so used to just using pencil And that was it. That was just like my go-to. That was just my bread and butter. But now I'm just kind of branching out. I want to use color. Like, I really want to learn how to use color. But I was so scared. Like, I was so scared I was going to just mess it up and mess up blending. But, you know, once I tried it, I'm like, okay, this isn't so bad. I can learn to do this. Like, I can learn to use this, and I can learn to perfect it and get better each time that I decide to draw with color. It's been tough, I'm not gonna lie. Like, it's been tough learning, but it's also been really fun. It's been very interesting and great just to experiment and kind of just get those right colors and to get that the perfect complexion right for this character. And so that's kind of what I'm doing here. I'm trying to like figure out shading and blending. And you know, I know Jose did it. I watched his drawing video of that of Esther, and he did it a completely different way. I didn't go about this the way that Jose did. I kind of just tried to figure out on my own. I didn't want to like follow the same technique that he did, because I was just, I don't know, I just wanted to do it differently. And I wish I could have showed that in this video, but I didn't show how I got to this point and creating her complexion. But we're already into it, so you guys can just keep watching and you guys can see later on now how it turns out. And I'm not gonna tell you guys, you just have to see to the end, and we'll see what you guys think. I hope you guys like it. All right, I'm gonna exit stage left for now. Thank you. noticed just now as I was editing this video is that as I was drawing the eyes, Esther's eyes, I could see that one eye is bigger than the other, and I'm seeing it now, and I'm just not realizing that, and it's like really bugging me. But honestly, obviously I continued with the drawing and I still finished it, and you know, it's not that bad. I'm not gonna beat myself up over the finish, because it doesn't look as bad as I thought. But I can see the difference in the eyes, like the left eye or the right eye is smaller than the other one. And this is something that I just noticed just now. Just probably, I've just been staring at this drawing for a while, and I can see it now. But I'm gonna continue to just be okay with it. I might fix it later on, but I did not fix it for this video, so you're gonna see a bigger eye than the other one, and you guys can just deal with that. But I promise you, it's not as bad as it looks as far as the finish goes, and you guys can just keep watching. All right, that's all I wanted to say. Thank you. Hi guys, we are nearing the end of this drawing and this has been such a fun journey. I've learned so much as I've been drawing and coloring Esther here. It's honestly, this is so therapeutic for me, drawing Esther and coloring Esther. I'm so satisfied on how this drawing turned out, because honestly I thought it was going to be a complete bust, but it's not half as bad, so I'm very happy at how it turned out. I just also want to let you guys know that I also did the blacklight version of Esther with a blacklight pen. I used a blacklight pen to like do little doodles around this drawing, pretty much to recreate what Jose Canella did in his drawing, and also just add a little, I just added a little flair to my own drawing, because I also love the black light concept that Esther uses in the movies. You know, when she paints, she creates all these really creepy doodles that no one else can see. They're pretty much hidden, and when she turns a black light, she pretty much turns on the black light when she's by herself, and she, you know, it's very disturbing, but I've always liked that concept they added into the movie. I thought it was really cool. But yeah, if you guys were wondering what I use for the black light effect, I use black light pens. Those always work. I was thinking about getting black light paint to do it, but pens, pretty simple. All right, you guys can enjoy the rest of this drawing. I'll shut up now. Guys, so we have finally reached the end of this video. I just want to say thank you guys so much for watching. You guys can look forward to more full-length time-lapse drawings of mine coming soon. Again, this is actually the first one in my Crazy Night series, where I draw a horror character for each day in October leading up to Halloween, and you guys can enjoy the ride up till then. And I have so many more drawings I want to show you guys, so many more videos, and yeah, you guys just stay tuned. If you guys like my content, please hit that like, subscribe, comment what you guys think of this video. I really appreciate you guys watching again, and yeah, you guys stay safe out there and look forward to my next video. Bye.